In today's video, we're looking at the confirmation of a brand new PlayStation 4 RPG, a game that's already been released on PC, but it's making its way over to Sony's console in 2019. Speaking of which, another PC title might be coming to PS4 in 2019, and that is DayZ, a game that's been known about for a very long time, of course went through some tumultuous development times, but it looks like DayZ's PS4 version might finally be hitting in 2019. Death Stranding is a game that a lot of people want to come in 2019, I don't know how likely that is, however, we might be getting a new trailer for the game very soon. And I want to round out today's video by taking a look at all of the new PlayStation 4 game releases this week. A very light week this week in terms of total number of game releases. However, I would say that all of the games being released and one expansion, they're all pretty major. So more on those at the end of this video. First, the isometric RPG Pathfinder Kingmaker is coming to the PlayStation 4 in 2019. THQ Nordic officially confirmed the news, and Pathfinder Kingmaker has already been released on PC, where it has a generally mixed reception on Steam. However, the game is still a work in progress. But THQ did say that the performance of the game from a commercial standpoint has been rather solid, and that's based on the PC sales. The game to many will be resembling of a title like Baldur's Gate. It does take place in an isometric perspective, and it does have an emphasis on realm building. A player's decision as a local lord affects gameplay. Character customization is also a key feature in the title. Of course, this is a more PC-centric RPG. However, we've been seeing games like this come over to PlayStation 4, with titles like Pillars of Eternity. Pillars of Eternity 2 will be making its way over to the PS4, and then we've had titles like Divinity Original Sin and Original Sin 2. It seems like they haven't resonated to a large degree from a commercial standpoint, but they're still fantastic games. And for the most part, with games like Pillars of Eternity and Divinity Original Sin, they've made a very smooth transition over to the PlayStation 4 and over to the DualShock 4 controls. So I hope for a similar level of success with Pathfinder Kingmaker when it does hit the PS4 sometime in 2019. Moving on from that, at one point in time, DayZ was one of the most popular games in the world. I think that time has completely gone by. However, it's still a very notable game, and a lot of gamers, including myself, are still very nostalgic with DayZ. And it was confirmed that DayZ will be coming to the PlayStation 4 sometime later in 2019. Now, I would take this with a grain of salt because DayZ has had a lot of release windows and times where people thought the game was finally going to be released, and it's missed a lot of those, and the game has been a part of Steam's early access program for a very, very long time, but it looks to finally be leaving early access by the end of the year. After that, we'll be seeing a release on the Xbox One, and then after that, we'll be seeing a release of the game on the PlayStation 4. Now, I really think if they got it right with DayZ, it could have become one of the biggest games of all time. However, with the development blunder that this game has gone through, and it really missed timing. Timing is such an important thing in gaming. You want to release a game when the anticipation, the hype, and notoriety of the game is at an absolute fever pitch, and they completely missed that with DayZ. There was a point in time where this was one of the biggest games, if not the biggest games in the entire world. Everybody was playing it. People were building PCs just to play DayZ. It got to a point where Arma 2, a game that had been released for a very long time, after DayZ, the mod to that game was released, it shot up to the top seller of Steam. There was a lot of traction, a lot of hype, and a lot of groundswell behind DayZ. That is, of course, completely gone. I don't think there's a chance for this game to be as big as it could have been. However, I do think if it does come to PlayStation 4, if it's a good PlayStation 4 version, which that's a massive question, I don't know how this game is going to do on the PS4 from a technical sense, but let's say it is very good. I do think there are going to be people that check it out just for the notoriety and the name value that DayZ still is holding on to ever since like 2012, 2013. However, I don't think it'll be that colossal commercial success that I think it really had the potential to be, and that's really unfortunate. At the very least, this is a story that I'm going to continue to monitor, and we'll see if DayZ is officially released on the PS4 in 2019, something I'm still not convinced with, but it was said in a press release, and it was announced that the game has sold 4 million copies across PC and Xbox One. It's an early access on PC and then the game preview program on Xbox One. That's why we don't have the game on the PlayStation 4, because there's no early access program on PlayStation. Moving on from that, Death Stranding is a game that I think so many of us are just confused with. On one sense, it is Hideo Kojima's next game. It's a PlayStation 4 exclusive. There's reason to be excited based on who's working on the game. However, when we actually look at what we've seen about the game, I think it just leaves us asking a lot of questions. And it looks like we might be getting another trailer for the game. And that was teased by an audio director at Kojima Production in Ludwig Forssell. He tweeted this. So Shinya Tsukamoto came by my room at work to watch a trailer today. Of course, I wasn't prepared and had to stall like an idiot. Hopefully, I did a good job not seeming like a total fanboy I am. Anyways, thanks for dropping by. By the way, if you don't know, Shinya Tsukamoto is a film director. That's why he was fanboying. But since he mentioned a trailer, this has led a lot of gamers to speculate that we might be seeing a brand new trailer at the Game Awards. Now, this does make a lot of sense. Jeff Keighley and Hideo Kojima are in very good terms, and we've seen other Kojima production titles at the Game Awards. Metal Gear Solid 5 got its infamous announcement back at the Game Awards, and we've seen Death Stranding make an appearance at the Game Awards before. So to see Death Stranding as a part of the big event again wouldn't shock me all too much. It's just that the content of the trailer is what I'm really questioning. Based on what I've seen from the trailers recently, every time we get a new trailer, we don't get a lot of content to really digest. I know there's a lot of people breaking down every single trailer, but right now I think we've gotten to a point where we need to see something substantial about Death Stranding, whether it be a release window, whether it be actual gameplay, something about Death Stranding that really captivates the entire gaming audience. Those that are big fans of Kojima are already captivated by the game. They're gonna buy the game. However, you need to get the entire gaming world invested into Death Stranding. And again, I just think at this point we need something a little bit more substantial, something that answers some questions, something that gets us really excited about the game, maybe even a release window. Maybe it does release in 2019, because the game's been in the works for quite a while. But again, I wouldn't be all too shocked if we do see a new trailer at the Game Awards. I just want to see a different kind of trailer, something a little bit more substantial. So we'll see if that comes to fruition. Again, the Game Awards will be held on December 6th, so that's something to be excited for. Probably gonna see a lot of new games, new game announcements, trailers, and of course a lot of 2018's best titles being commemorated for their success. And lastly, I do want to go over all of the new game releases this week. We only have 3 games to go over, so for the holiday season, this is one of the lightest weeks. However, each of these 3 releases are pretty notable, so let's get right into it. First of all, we'll have Marvel Spider-Man 2nd DLC in Turf Wars. That'll be dropping on November 20th. Probably don't have to sell you guys on this, as if you played the first DLC, you're probably going to check out the second DLC. If you enjoyed Spider-Man, this is going to be more content for you to delve into. The first DLC was quite good, a little bit short, but I think that's what we were going to expect, considering that all of this content is available with the season pass. But again, DLC 2 Turf Wars will be dropping on November 20th. Battlefield 5 will be seeing its official release on November 20th. A lot of gamers have been playing it on Xbox One and PC through Origin Access. I do believe the Deluxe Edition gave you access to the game a little bit early, but the game will officially be released on November 20th. There doesn't seem to be a lot of anticipation for Battlefield 5, which is quite unfortunate. I do see this game doing pretty badly from a commercial standpoint, but considering EA's blundering with the promotion of this game, they really messed up the promotion with Star Wars Battlefront 2, and it did seem like they learned a lot from that. However, they messed up again with Battlefield 5 just based on some of the quotes and some of the things that they've been saying. And based on the early reviews, critically it's doing okay, but we're talking in that 7.5 to 8 range. Battlefield 1 did fare much better from a critical standpoint, and if you want a quality Battlefield experience, Battlefield 1 is on sale at the PlayStation Store right now for $3.99, so instead of paying $59.99 for BF5, BF1 for just $4 isn't a bad buy. And lastly, we have the release of a major PlayStation VR title in Beat Saber. That'll be dropping on November 20th. Beat Saber is one of the most popular VR titles on PC. It's a very slick music rhythm game, and the PlayStation 4 version is coming with some additional content, extra tracks. And if you have PSVR, you've yet to play Beat Saber. It's one of the notable VR experiences on PC. To see it make the transition to PlayStation VR, that is very exciting. And I've been saying a lot, but PSVR's library is getting so much depth to it, and with the headset being down to $200, we're talking about the Astrobot and Moss bundle. That is a sick price for the headset, and now you've got great games like Beat Saber. You have the aforementioned Astrobot and Moss. You have games like Firewall Zero Hour. There are a lot of high quality games on PSVR, and now's a great time to pick it up, especially with the release of Beat Saber. Again, it's coming on November 20th. And that's going to conclude this video. Pathfinder Kingmaker will be coming to the PlayStation 4 in 2019. DayZ looks to be coming to the PS4 in 2019 as well. Let's see if that holds up to be true, but the game does look to be leaving early access later this year. Death Stranding might be getting a new trailer, and it's very likely we'll be seeing that at the Game Awards. And again, this week's PS4 game releases include Marvel Spider-Man DLC 2, Turf Wars, Battlefield 5, and Beat Saber, some very notable releases. That's gonna conclude this video. Sound off with all of your thoughts in the comments section down below. Thank you for watching, and goodbye. Thank you.